Well, spring is coming despite what it looks like outside. Well, we kind of know that it's going to be nice on Monday, close to zero. And if you're considering some do-it-yourself projects at home, because spring is the time of the year that a lot of people like to do that, we've got some ideas about handy tools that could very well make your job easier. Vince Young is with KMS Tools and Equipment, opening a brand new store in Edmonton this week. And what have you brought for us today?
A couple different things. Spring is around the corner. Doesn't look like it, but it is. And so I brought some things for to make your life easier renovating outside as well as the inside. So I think we'll talk about...
Start outside with the deck.
Exactly. This is a Kreg deck jig. This is new on the market. And what this allows you to do is traditionally, when people would do, let's say, a five-quarter deck, they would actually have to drill down into the material. And what that would do is it would expose it to the elements, and it would do... It just looked unsightly. Yeah. This jig actually allows you... comes with spacers, comes with the jig and the bits and such. And so what this allows you to do is get your quarter inch spacing, if that's what you choose to do, align the jig, and it's just as simple as drilling a hole and then actually taking a screw, which actually kind of remains hidden
right through that jig,
right through the jig again. And then basically what that does is it hides the screw.
Hides the screw, and so they're not on top.
Exactly, so I'll now have a really beautiful, nice flat surface.
Great.
Yep.
So that is relatively new to the market, does
it? Yep, it is. Yep.
Well, it makes building a deck a whole lot easier. Now, you have some stuff over here. You're talking about some oscillating tools and how they can help.
This is for the inside. Nice thing about the oscillating tools is they come now in cordless with the advent of 12-volt lithium technology, which a lot of people, a lot of the different suppliers are utilizing now.
What's the deal with the lithium battery? Is that last longer and it's smaller?
There's definitely advantages.
The
yep. You can fit 3.6 volt per battery cell versus 1.2 in an iCAD, that kind of thing. They're a lot lighter. They hold their charge better.
Yep.
But they come in electric as well. And the advantage to them is they sand, they cut, they can remove grout, they can do all sorts of things. So kind of what I've done here is I've just brought a piece of maple laminate flooring. And traditionally when you do a laminate flooring, when you actually try and bump it up to, let's say, your door jams and that kind of stuff, one of the problems has always been how do you actually, if you replace a carpet or something, how do you actually underscore those door jams? So typically what these will allow you to do is you get a flat blade, and I can actually just use this as a template.
Yeah.
And then actually just, if there's a door jam here, I would just be able to cut along and underscore that door jam, pull that out, and then actually
slide it right in.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay.
And so what else, the other things I brought here is when you're actually doing your door trim and finishing, there's different brad nails for different applications.
Right.
So I've got a 23-gauge pinner, which is great if you're doing trim work around a mantel place, a fireplace hearth, something like that, up into the new Max 18-gauge, which will actually do your baseboard and some of your door trim, up into 15 and 16-gauge nailers, which do door jams and casings and that kind of stuff.
You can shoot the nails right into it.
Yeah, with a compressor, absolutely. And there's some cordless models
as
well.
What's newer about these than older models?
In North America, the 23-gauge and the 21-gauge is relatively new, where you've actually got very, very fine pins,
yeah.
And the idea is when you actually shoot those into your trim pieces, the holes are less exposed. Less material to fill in those little holes and that kind of stuff.
Okay, well, you're opening a new store that we had mentioned, yep. KMS Tools and Equipment. What's unique about this store that people may not find in other places?
Well, we focus entirely on tools and tool-related accessories. So unlike a home center where you get lumber and plumbing, and fixtures and all that kind of stuff, that's all we do. So we are experts in that, and we have everything from welding through to hand tools, through into the full gamut of safety and woodworking, into car parts, custom car parts for old vehicles, and everything in between.
And you have cookies, too.
We have bench cookies, yeah.
Cookies like these, bench cookies, which go underneath. Correct?
Exactly, yeah, for panel work. So this would actually hold it in place. It grips it, so if you're sanding, it doesn't slide around. It allows me to take a router and, let's say, do a trim piece in here without cutting into the cabinet or the base underneath it. You've actually got the cones which go on the cookies, so I can actually take a panel and I can actually put that on there and paint.
Among the many other things that you have.
Absolutely.
KMS Tools and Equipment opens Thursday. It's at 14520. 14520, that is 145th Street, right? And 111th Avenue. Vince Young, thanks very much for coming in.
Thank you very much. Appreciate
it. Much success with the new store.
Thank you.
Women's clothing for the CTV News team provided by Southgate. Southgate, this winter, burn brightly.